my goodness, this was a sight to behold and a day to be celebrated in Toronto. More than a million people clogged the city's downtown. They wanted to get a first-hand glimpse of the Raptors, the newly crowned NBA champions. There are fresh questions today as well about whether the city maybe tried to pull off something for which it was simply not prepared. And of course, all of that euphoria had a black cloud over it as well, a bit of a cloud, the shooting that wounded four people. We're going to get some answers to those questions. I want to welcome my guest right here in studio. He is Toronto Police Chief Mark Saunders, and he had certainly a busy day yesterday. And today as well, looking at questions, four people injured. I know three people are in custody. What's the latest on that shooting investigation?
Well, right now we're looking for a person of interest, and that the description that we have from eyewitness accounts is male, white, between 5'9" and 6 feet, with short light brown hair, heavy build, wearing a white button-down t-shirt. So that's a person that we're looking for. Last seen going westbound, and we're trying to determine the involvement that that person has. But when you look at the scene and the setting and the location, we have a lot of video footage to go through. We know that there are witnesses because we had 2 million people there, and we're trying to just focus in on those that were in that geographical space at about 3:45 in the evening to see if they can add pieces to the puzzle so we can get a bigger picture of exactly what took place and who was involved in the situation.
I wasn't near that shooting, but I was one of the people with a phone trying to get some pictures as well. Sometimes the cell service was interrupted actually a lot of time. Mm-hmm. How do you get that many people or get that message out, and then you've got to deal with mountains of video to go through?
Yeah, you do it piece by piece. I mean, the evidence is there. The digital footprint will be there. You know, when you're downtown, you're going to get filmed a multitude of times during the course of a day. There's no doubt that once we hone in and focus on specifically that location, we can start working it backwards. So you peel the layers of the onion, so to speak, in order to conduct any investigation. And the uniqueness to this one is we had 2 million people in a very small, congested area, which I think will provide more opportunity.
Could it have been worse? When you talk about, you know, small congested area, 2 million people, I'm thinking, oh my goodness, that could have been chaos.
I generally don't answer hypotheticals. I deal with what happened. And in this case, the event was fantastic when we talk about the amount of people that were there and why they were there. And yes, we had this situation that happened. When you look at how quick the law enforcement responded and were able to apprehend three people with two firearms, that's a good day for the most part. Although I will say, and I don't want to diminish, that when you have gunplay in the city of Toronto, we recognize that it is an urban city, and we collectively work with our partners to figure out what we can do to reduce the gunplay in the city.
Bill Blair, former, you know, used to wear your uniform
before
he became minister.
Yeah.
He said that, you know, it's really an aberration. Do you think it is today an aberration for somebody to bring a gun to a party like that?
Well, I don't want to define it, but what I will say is that the fact that the men and women who were working, all the first responders, did a fantastic job, and I can't commend them enough for moving towards that situation in that moment, which we do on a regular basis, and professionally, it was a celebratory event. We kept it that way. We did not want to transfer it into a security event, but we had the capabilities of doing that. Most people were there. It was a once-in-a-lifetime for them, and we wanted to give the public the opportunity to celebrate the event in that way, and I think we did that fantastically. And when we had to transition in that small segment of geographical space, we did so fantastically.
How much kudos do you pass on to Devlin, who NBA play-by-play commentator, who kept the crowd pretty calm? He was up on the stage, and you know, he was trying to keep things in perspective and not have people panic.
Well, I didn't hear what Devlin had to say, and so I won't comment to that. I will focus on the resources that I had control of, and I will say that I was very pleased with the way in which the men and women and also the transit enforcement folks helped in that situation as well.
I saw you shaking your head kind of when I was reading the intro to our conversation, and I said, you know, there are people posing the question, was Toronto really ready to handle something like this? And you were kind of going, of course, you know, we were. Do you think?
I just thought it was a dumb question.
Why don't you tell me what you really think?
Well, no, I'll be honest about it. The Toronto Police Service is the largest municipal service in the country. We deal with mass situations on a regular basis. We're highly trained. We have the highest level of training in the city. Our role is not to predict what's going to happen. Our role is to be, as much as we can, intelligence-led and also understanding the environment and what we need to have the capability of transitioning into. Mm-hmm. We've done it a multitude of times, and this is one of those times. So we had the right resources in place, which had the quick outcomes. And when you look at this entire event, a lot of people that I spoke to had no idea what happened until they got home.
Yeah.
Now, the younger folks obviously were Twittering and using social media platforms, but the vast majority of people had no effect by the situation, not diminishing those that were involved in that gunplay.
I'm not just talking about the shooting, though. I'm talking about the lack of barricades along the parade route. You used the word dumb. Maybe I can throw that back out, too. Was it a dumb idea not to have those barricades there to turn what should have been a 2.5-hour parade into a 7-hour parade that kept people, you know, in the sun, thirsty, not being able to get to the bathroom because people wouldn't let them back in the spot that they had waited for 8 hours to get to? I mean, was there something dumb about all of that?
No, I still would not focus on that. I will look at the event as a whole, which was celebratory, and the vast majority of citizens that were there.
But I'm asking you to focus on that one thing, like the barricades. Should they have been there?
Oh, is there always room for improvement? Yes.
Yeah.
I certainly now is not the environment for me to give a lecture on security and process
totally
and procedure, and also laws when it comes to controlling people. I think that everything in place was there for a reason, and we always debrief to make sure are there opportunities for improvement. We also understand that the strength of success really does rely on a partnership. So it's not just Toronto Police in here do everything. We work with our EMS, we work with our fire, we work with the city, we work with MLSE, and you know, the takeaways are going to be left up to each individual. I think, by and large, the vast majority of the 2 million people there had a fantastic time. And I think when you look at the numbers, it speaks to that as well. And yeah, there are going to be people that may not have had a different experience. And you know, that's where we learn and that's where we get stronger.
I want to thank you for your time. I wish I had more time. It's great of you to come in here. And I know when I've talked to friends and family who were out there, they had a great time. There's always somebody who kind of tries to ruin the party, though, isn't there?
You bet. Thank you so much.
I want to thank you for your time, Chief.
Thanks.
Toronto Police Chief Mark Saunders, right here in studio.